today, bringing you my first review of the Bird Divergent, 2019 Bird Divergent. I had this boat about 2 weeks, and I just been shooting it, trying to break in the streams. This is the boat. It's a 28-inch axle-to-axle, a 6.5-inch brace height. The IBO speed is 338, but you know, once we start putting stuff on the string, you know, it's gonna take it down. Then the arrow's fine, and the weight of the arrow, all this gonna take it down. So yeah, we know that. Let's see, what else? The let off is 75%. The draw weight come in 45 to 60, and then you got 55 to 70. This is a 55 to 70. The price range on this is $6.99, and that's just with nothing on it. But you also can get the Ready to Hunt that comes with the quiver, the sight, everything for $8.99. Gotta look on their website. But so far, my first impression of this bow, when I picked it up, first time the lady gave it to me, rather, and I held it in my hand, this bow is light. It's real light compared to my bar cruise I had. I could hold it, and it felt kind of heavy. That's why I wanted a short axle-to-axle bow. For some smaller and more lighter, because my bar cruise is 32-inch. Axle-to-axle, this is 28, and plus I hunt in the tree stand, and I really didn't like it this year when I went on my deer hunt, but it just wasn't right. But it was a good shooting bow to start out to shoot. But let's see, I took notes for the last 2 weeks, so let's see, the light. Yeah, I already explained, it's lightweight already. The hand shock. The hand shock in this bow, I mean, it's literally no vibration here. And I just put the limb savers on here just to make it more quiet. But with the sun, with these, it's already quiet, and the hand shock is, when you shoot it, you feel like nothing there. You don't feel nothing. No vibration, nothing. And the sound of it, like I said, I put the limb savers on there to add a little bit from the vibration just in case it might come after the strings break in. But so far, it's not really loud, nothing like that. Let's see, paper tuning. When I had my local archery shop to paper tune it, out the box it was shooting bullet holes. They didn't really have to do nothing to it. You know, just set my draw limb, my draw weight, add my wrist, and add my sight. And, you know, add my stabilizer. Straight out the box, it was, you know, shooting bullet holes like it's supposed to. And that's what it's doing now. It's still shooting straight. Everything's still good. I probably got close to 75 to 100 shots on there. Haven't broken in all the way. I just wanted to give a review first. Let's see. So far, after 20 yards, I got the pins on set for 20 and 30 yards, because I'm going to go to a single pin this year, because I guess because the speed of this bow, my pins are too close. And I don't want no problems coming this big season. Compared to my cruiser, it was, you know, kind of a little bit slow. So the pins were, you know, spread it out a little bit. This one, the pins are real close. I don't know if you can see that, but those two top pins, that's the 20 and 30 pins. And you see how close they are. So just imagine if you're trying to sight in a deer, and then you got to pick. Let's see, this color is real tree camo. I had two choices. I was gonna pick either the iron or the real tree camo, but some kept telling me, you know, go with the real tree camo since, you know, I'm on camo every day during hunting season, so I might as well go on and blend in all the way, have everything blended and matching. Let's see, the colors on the string, I don't know why they did it, but the colors is like a orange and brownish. They could have, you know, put like a camo color string on here to match it. But once I break it in before deer season, I'm gonna get the strings changed to a camo color and get everything. You know, everything's gonna be matching right now. Right now it's just shooting. You know, I had to take everything out my other bow, put on here until I get my sight. You know, and my stabilizer. I can't decide if I'm gonna go with a stabilizer or a tacticam. More likely I'll probably go with a tacticam on here so I can video my hunts and have my GoPro too. But I'm gonna go with a one pin sight. Right now, this is an IQ sight. So this is good for, you know, for my bird cruiser. For let you know a lot of stuff. Let's see, the valley on here. That's the problem I was having. The valley on here is real spongy. You know, it wants to shoot by itself. Any little movement in your hand, in your arm rather, and it wants to fire. You know, the valley is real thin. You know, let's see. What else? Since I've been shooting, I ain't had no problems with it. The draw cycle on it. The draw cycle is real smooth. It's just, the only problem is the valley. The valley is just not, you know, it's not heavy enough. It's just thin. And I guess that's about it. That's the real only problem I was having with the valley. You know, I mean, that's pretty much it. I got videos, I'm gonna post videos of the speed. I say the second day I had it, I took it and got a corner graph to show the speed, because my arrows, I shoot eastern axis, 400 spine, and the arrows, they was weighing in at 398. And My draw length is 27.2. My draw weight, I got to sit at 60 pounds. Like I said, my other bow, when I had it at 60 pounds, I could barely pull it back. So I had them sit it at 55 like my other one. Man, I had to take it up because it was just a little bit too easy, you know. But the draw cycle, like I said, since it's real smooth, so I should have no problem going up to 70 pounds, maxing it out. Let's see, what else? I got videos of me shooting for the last 2 weeks. You know, showing the draw cycle, showing the valley of it. You know, I even got a video of me shooting it on my knees. I'm gonna get videos later shooting from my tree stand and shooting from out my ground blind. Cause like I said, I wanted a small axle bow. So they say it's for tree stand hunters and ground blind. So I really want to see if it's short enough for my ground blind. Let's see. That's pretty much it. You know, overall, I'm satisfied with it. You know, I really don't have that many complaints about it besides, like I said, the valley. Other than that, you know, when I first picked this bow up, and man, it's just super light. I fell in love with it. This is gonna be my new hunting rig for this season. So I just wanted to make it quick. I don't want to keep it long because this is my first review, so I really don't know what I'll talk about. So if you like it, you already know what to do. I'm not gonna tell you what to do because you don't see multiple YouTube videos. I have more videos of it. And I'm a video my turkey season leading all the way into deer season this year. As you've seen on some of my videos, my deer season, I really couldn't video it for work and stuff. When I did get out there, I really didn't see nothing for my hunting public land. So this is going to be my new rig. Like I said, this was 2019 by Divergent, 28-inch Astro. And the bow on the way, 3.9 pounds. And we also know once we start adding stuff, you know, sight, rest, and all that, it takes it up a little bit more. But so far I got my sight, my wrist stabilized. It still feels like it's not too heavy. But I'm going to see once I add, you know, start adding all the final stuff on it. And then I'll let y'all know. But like I said, I just wanted to make this first review of the bow. So I hope you like it.